What's up, peeps? Today I'm going to go over the Xfinity app, in particular how to manage your Wi-Fi connection. So there's a couple different apps for Xfinity. With the Xfinity app, you can protect your devices. It's hooked into your Xfi gateway. It does the normal things like password management, parental controls, and how to manage your device to protect. So when you first go into the Xfinity app, you get the overview. You get a couple of different notifications. You can now share your Wi-Fi using the QR code. That makes it nice and easy, so you don't actually have to remember any really weird names or anything. You can just hit share Wi-Fi and then scan the QR code. You don't have to actually share what the password is. Next part down, you have people. Now these are profiles that you can create, and that's one of the key benefits of managing with the Xfinity app. As you can see, I have mine, my wife, and then I have one for random, you know, guests, people to visit and different things. You can also restart your gateway and set up the equipment and so forth. Let's go to people. So there's a couple of different ways. You can go to people from the main screen here, or at the bottom, you have the connect tab, and then next to that is the people tab. And this will show you all the profiles that you have set up. So there's me, my wife, the household, and then random. So let's go to my profile here. So one of the first things you can do, you can customize it with a picture. You just hit that little cog at the top. You can pick a picture, change the name. Here's one of the big benefits. Create downtime schedule. So rather than trying to change the password or say, hey, don't use your devices at a certain time, you can go in and set up an actual downtime schedule using the app. And you don't even need to be in the home or anything. You can do it when you're out. You can create one. So let's say between the hours of 9 and 7, I don't want somebody to use their device on the network. So this is only for the network. You would go in here, hit get started, introducing downtime, automatically pauses internet access for all of Damon's assigned devices when connected to the home network. So the first part is you want to create the profile, move their devices to this profile, and then we hit next. Automatically pause internet access for all of Damon's assigned devices when connected to your home network. So now I get to pick which icon I want to use. So let's pick the nighttime one. I can have it for study time, time for dinner, anytime. So we're picking the night one, bedtime. Now you get to just select the days of the week. And it's as easy as just clicking on a day. You can do Monday through Friday, or I could just do certain days like Sunday night or whatever combination I want, or every single day. Select the time range. So this means the pause access is when it will restrict access to the devices that are assigned to this profile. So let's say 9 o'clock, I'm gonna put 9 o'clock, 9 p.m. The internet service on these devices will pause and then have it resume at 7 a.m. the next day. I would then hit apply. It's now setting up downtime. So my devices will not be able to access this Wi-Fi during the hours between 9 p.m. and 7 a.m. And I can just go back into that. And let's say I want to delete it. I just hit there, hit delete, and it's saying, are you sure? And it's deleted. Some of the other things I can do, I can set up an active time limit. So I go in there, let's say Monday through Friday, I only want them to have access for 3 hours. I can go all the way down to 30 minutes, or I can go all the way up to 12 hours. And that's on the weekdays. So it says, set a limit and get an alert when Damon nears the end of their active time on your network. So that's for the week, 12 hours access. You can also set it for the weekends. And then you have the option at the bottom. Once the active time limit is reached, pause Damon's devices for the rest of the day. So there you go. So once I reach my limit, that's it. It's going to pause, and then they would have to come to me, or I would have to go to somebody and say, hey, can I get some more time, or, you know, give me more access. Next one, turn on active time details. So this is basically reporting, turn on to start seeing the active time of 100 plus top ranked apps across Damon's devices when connected. So this is literally going to show what apps I'm using. Here we go. I'm going to agree to it. I'm going to turn it on. I've actually never used this one. This is new. Really don't have any use to use it, but it'd be interesting to see how I'm using my internet right now. It's updating and it's active. So I'll take a look at that. Then I have the parental controls. Settings will apply to all Damon's assigned devices. Turn on to reduce the risk of accessing objectionable websites and apps and enable protective search settings for Google, Bing, YouTube. Viewable content will be deemed appropriate for all ages. So this is going to restrict only deemed viewable for all ages. So if I turn that on, it's going to restrict what I can search. Here's the profile setting at the bottom. Once again, change the name, change the little icon. All right. And then at the bottom, there's the delete profile. So it's a great way of setting up and monitoring and managing your profiles for guests, children, and it's all one-stop shop. So the main thing is that you want them to have their device connected to your network, then you'll be able to manage the device and their access. This is only for your modem. So if they're connected to another access point, it won't work. But at least if they're only connected to this access point, you'll be able to monitor and control their access. If you got any questions, leave them in the comments. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this helped you. If it did, leave a comment, hit the like button, share it with a friend. And remember, take care of each other. Peace out. I'll see you all soon.